Companies and some Maya ceremonies in different communities. They also play the wind instruments made of a ceramic, like ocarines, whistles, different types of flutes. They had different shapes like jaguars or deer, and after the 16th century, the Spanish people brought other animals, the horses or goats that are common now. The next instrument is the tarantel. It was like a drum, and they played this instrument with antlers. In Guatemala, it accompanies small processions called posadas in December. Scenes of the Bible about Christmas, where you can see images of Joseph and Mary on their way to Bethlehem. And many Mayan instruments accompany religious activities of the Catholic Church, the religion that the Spaniards brought in that time. Let's continue. When a horse dies, its teeth become loose and they make the sound. Accompanies traditional dances, specifically in Ciudad Vieja, a small town close to Antigua, on December 7th. Now you can see ceramic drums as in the past. They are made of wood. It's common to see in front of the Catholic Church a person playing the drum, specifically in Hollywood, because there are many processions for Easter. The next instrument, here in Guatemala, it is called huiro or raspador. The Mayas used the bones of different animals to make the instrument, but now people use the tecomate for it's like the gold. The next instrument is another design of a drum. Its name is tum or tumcul, and it has three different sounds. Type of wood that people use for making the keys of the marimbas, the national instrument, because it's hard and it has a good sound. To have this small drum, it's not very common, but it accompanies some processions. Its name is adufa. It's a wood covered by skin of different animals too, and it accompanies the processions, specifically in Baja Verapaz in the north. Let's see a copy of the marimba. The Mayas played the marimba before the Spaniards came. Maybe the idea came with African slaves that the Spanish people brought. The word marimba is not Maya. The first was played by one person. It had only like sounds, and people used the chords for making the resonant voices. All the marimbas in Guatemala have a special process. Here we have a small copy. There is a hole in each resonant box. This wax around the hole. After that, the wax is covered with a piece of a skin of the pig intestine. They produce in each key the sound. It's like a double vibration, very important. So this is the first marimba, and it had different changes during the years. In some communities, you can see big marimbas. They are played by many people, and they still use the gourds. This type of marimba is common specifically in Solola, small communities around the lake Atiti. Let's see the next. In this case, the difference. Instead of the gourds, the resonant boxes are made of wood, and that's why they have like a hard sound, but you can see metal on them. And in Guatemala, we have a modern marimba. Here you can see a copy. Normally, this marimba is huge, and it's played by many people. Its name is Marimba Pura. It's like the piano with double keyboards. It was created in Quetzaltenango, Xela, well-known city, in 1890. And it's accompanied by other instruments like guitar, the saxophones, and those are the orchestras. Let's see the next instrument. It's a special flute. Its name is Chirimia. It came with the Spaniards, and its origin is Arabic and Moorish. It's like a saxophone. It has a double reed, palm leaf, metal, and wood. It's accompanied by a drum. Here in front, we have a representation of the procession. They are carried by people on the streets with the patron saint, but in Guatemala, there are Catholic saints and deities, images that are not recognized by the Catholic religion because of the practice of the syncretism. If you go to some communities, you can see sometimes Maya ceremonies inside the Catholic Church, because when the Spaniards came, they built many Catholic churches on top of the sacred altars, and that's why you can see this mixture of both. Mm-hmm.